It's a fact to state that Key West has some of the most beautiful hotels, bed and breakfast inns, and resorts in the world. They seem to just greet you with warm breezes, breathtaking views, bright colors, and of course, island-style art. This morning, we're going to focus specifically on the Southernmost Hotel Collection. Matt, thank you for being back on the show with me today.
Thank you, Jennifer, for having me again. Well, I appreciate it.
Yeah, it's great having you, and I guess we had you here a while ago to talk about the Brewfest.
Yes, Brewfest Key West was a fabulous success. Thank you for helping us promote that. I certainly appreciate it.
Of course. Let's talk about the Southernmost Hotel Collection and what makes you guys so unique.
Well, I think there's two things that make us extremely unique in the lodging community of Key West. One of them is our exceptional customer service, and the second is our location. In regards to exceptional customer service, we like to make every guest feel that they are the only guest staying at our property. We want them to have the time of their lives, and we empower our employees to do whatever they need to do to make sure our guests have a good time, whether they're for an anniversary, their first time to Key West. We want our employees to interact with the guest as if someone is coming to your home, and we have something called the shoes rule, where put yourself in the guest's shoes and do whatever you can do to make them happy and enjoy their vacation. Secondly, our location in Key West, we're located at the corner of Duval and South Street, which is a fabulous location in my opinion, because every one of our guests can stay, go to any of our facilities at any of our properties, which means you can go over to our pool that's right on the ocean, right at the end of South Street there, mm-hmm. Overlook the pool and the ocean while you're lounging in your Chase Lounge chairs having a drink at our Shores Bar. But more importantly, and our guest feedback tells us, they like the fact that they're on Duval Street, they can go down Duval Street, you know, the main attraction in town, mm-hmm. have a great time at the restaurants, bars, and attractions, mm-hmm. and yet leave that area and come to more of the quiet, secluded end of Duval Street, closer to the southernmost point, mm-hmm. and just be, while you're in Key West, you can experience two great, type of experiences, mm-hmm. the wild and craziness, if you want to get involved in that,
right.
or get away from that all in quiet, serene location that mm-hmm. we have.
And that's nice, to just kind of get away from that. It definitely is, and you have the beauty that people can enjoy mm-hmm. as well as that quiet. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about your beach cafe for a second.
Ah, great, thank you. Fine cuisine at affordable prices overlooking the ocean is our motto. In a beachy setting, we're not fine dining, we're fine cuisine. And people sometimes get that mixed up. So you can come there, you can come with your family, the kids can play out on the beach while you're having dinner inside, or you can come for any of our meal periods, breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Some of the things that we get comments about, of course, is our fine cuisine, but also, my daughter tells me we have the best coconut shrimp she's ever tasted anywhere. Obviously, it's my daughter and it's our restaurant, so she does feel that way. But we have some great happy hours from 5 till 7 every night. We've got grace pricing and happy hours. And we try and gear our menu to the natural things we have here in Key West is the ocean and fish. So we're very, always have lots of fish on the menu, fish specials and things. And we've got some wonderful people working there, and it's just a great spot. You know, come enjoy a nice dinner mm-hmm. While you're looking out the ocean or mm-hmm. right at breakfast.
Right.
So either one, all three meal periods are a good time to come to the Southernmost Beach Cafe.
Your daughter's right. You do have delicious coconut shrimp. All right, I've had it, so I can attest to it.
Great.
Let's talk about, you guys have won so many different awards and accomplishments, Matt, so I know you're very proud of that.
Mm-hmm.
What are you most proud of?
Oh, what am I most proud of? Well, this year, I'm happy to say that the Southernmost Hotel Collection received the Florida Keys and Key West Lodging Association Property of the Year. There's some stiff competition in Key West when you think about the other well-known hotels we have in Key West. So we were very, very proud to win that as a company. It was great morale boost for all the employees, too, because of all the hard work and effort we do put back into our properties, and we continue to put capital and money back into our properties to fix our rooms up. Mm-hmm. So the competition's stiff. We're very proud to win that. Also, TripAdvisor ranked the Southernmost on the Beach the second most romantic hotel on the East Coast a few years ago. And when you think about all that was completely guest feedback, so every time a guest would stay with us, they'd go on TripAdvisor, a social media site, and rank us very, very highly. And I'm proud to say every single one of our properties has received a TripAdvisor. You know, we're in the top 10% continuously, and that's because of our beautiful facilities. We like to keep them immaculate, meticulous, are our words we use, whether you're walking around the grounds looking at the property or walking to your hotel room. We want it immaculate and meticulous. It's always fun to win the Key West Chamber of Commerce Christmas Lighting Awards.
Mm-hmm.
We've won that In the 23 years I've been at the Southernmost Hotel Collection, I think we've won that at least a dozen, 15 times. I can't say we've won it, we placed in the top three, so that's always a fun thing also.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm very proud of anything to do with TripAdvisor because that's social media and that's people grading us that come and stay with us.
Who does the Christmas lighting?
It's our maintenance crew and our landscaping crew get together and do a terrific job of being creative and putting the lights up. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of work. I mean, you start right after Fantasy Fest or after it.
But it's worth it in the
end.
All right, real quick, we're running out of time right now. What is the number one thing that a tourist needs to do if they're staying at the Southernmost Hotel Collection?
Go to one of our schools. Every week we have two beer schools and one wine school. If you pass the course with the test we give you afterwards, you'll get a certificate from one of our beer school or wine school. One of our schools, you actually get a certificate. We put your name on it. You get a caricature of me with my curly mustache, and you get to take it home and put it at your desk and put it up on your wall at your bar in your basement. But that's one of the things our guests really enjoy. Lots of school, lots of activities, anything from wall hockey to hula hoop. We'll teach you snorkel school. We have several schools to try and educate you on the different things you can do in Key West.
That's great. I think the picture is worth it right there. Picture with you, Matt. All right. Thank you for being on the show this morning. I'm going to take a quick break, but I'll be right back after these messages. Stay with me.